Fox Sports.
We are Fox Sports. We are San Diego.
Late last season, Clayton Richard emerged as one of the more dependable starters on the Padres roster.
Ramirez to Schimp. Back to first base. A double play.
Clayton re-signed with the Padres in the offseason and plans to help San Diego build towards a brighter future.
I know what we're doing here is special. It's an exciting group of players. And I think here, they're so young and we're so talented. That sticks out.
Tonight, Richard takes on the Rangers as Padres spring training rolls on from Peoria. Next. The sun is setting in the desert as the Cactus League schedule continues. A beautiful night after a warm day in Arizona. We welcome you inside the Peoria Sports Complex. It's the Texas Rangers and the San Diego Padres. Hi again, everybody. I'm Don Orsillo along with Mark Sweeney. Welcome to Padres Baseball. As tonight the Padres take on the Texas Rangers, and Clayton Richard will be on the mound. Certainly struggled last year as a reliever with the Chicago Cubs, but very good with the Padres as a starter.
I think it had a lot to do with health, and when he came over to San Diego, he had familiarity with Darren Balsley, the pitching coach. That always helps. But when it comes down to it, Clayton Richard has to induce the ground ball. He changed his arm angle to the previous time when he was with the San Diego Padres, and the ground ball rate went up. Yes, you can see over 64%, but also the record, the ERA, went along with it. Pitched important innings at the end of the year, signed back. This is a staple, especially left-handed, but Clayton Richard definitely brings that veteran enthusiasm that I think this staff definitely needs.
It'll be fun to watch Clayton Richard in tonight's action and some of the returning Padres here back from the WBC. We'll also have some news and notes for you, some moves today by the Padres. Michelle Margot will check in with those news and notes right after this. San Diego presents Padres Baseball, brought to you by Petco, where the healthy pets go. by Sequan Casino. Play, win together in the heart of San Diego. And by Nissan. The choice is clear. Save on a new Nissan now. Shop ChooseNissan.com. Back in the desert as the sun is setting on a warm day. We set it down to field level at Michelle Margot.
Thank you so much, John. Yeah, some news out of camp today. Paul Clemens, who was vying for a spot in the rotation, has been released per Andy Green. Andy, of course, wishes him nothing but the best and hopes that he lands on his feet. But in other news, two familiar faces back in the Padres clubhouse today, Jalys Chacin and Yonhair Vasilarte, back from representing Team Venezuela in the World Baseball Classic. Here's a look at their numbers from that tournament. Chacin had a huge smile on his face when he talked about being able to play in his new home ballpark of Petco Park. That, of course, was in the second round of the tournament. Andy Green not pleased with the lack of playing time Solarte got, but he will be starting at second base tonight here in Peoria. When we come back, Clayton Richard gets the ball for the Padres as they take on the Texas Rangers. We'll be right back. Peoria Sports Complex as we get ready for Rangers Padres. The Padres have taken the field. It is still warm here, 87 degrees, even though the sun has set, but still on the warm side after a better than 95 degree day today here. It's about 96, 97 at times, and on the warm side, as spring training winds down, Padres playing today, and on the mound is Clayton Richard. As he gets ready, let's check out the visiting Texas Rangers starting lineup. Rangers coming over here tonight. Of course, Jeff Banister, the manager of the Rangers, and they're hoping for big things this year. Drew Robinson will lead it off. He is in left field with Elvis Andrus at shortstop batting second. Rougned Odor is at second base with Ryan Rua, the DH. Nomar Mazara is in right field with Cesar Puello in center. James Loney at first base with Brett Hayes doing the catching. And it is Doug Burnler who is at third base and batting ninth for the Texas Rangers. Defensively tonight for the Padres, a left to right across the outfield. It is Hunter Renfro, Travis Jankowski, and Jabari Blash. Third to first, Corey Spangenberg, Luis Sardinez. It is Yonhair Vasilarte back, and he's at second base with Will Myers at first base, and Austin Hedges doing the catching for Clayton Richard. So Richard, who, of course, is vying for a spot in the rotation, appears to have one locked up of the guys in the mix for a spot. And, of course, last year, pretty good for him in the second half of the season.
Yeah, if we take a look at the scouting report for Clayton Richard, get the sinkers and have success with that, and still build on that strength. I think that's what you got to have. But also now kick in that intensity a little bit more, and you'll see Clayton Richard attack the hitters with all his stuff, mostly the two-seamers.
Now Drew Robinson leading it off here for the Rangers in the first. Richard changing his number this year to a single digit, number three.
Yeah, it looks odd at times, but that's what he wanted to do. It looks good because obviously he fills out a uniform when it comes down to it. Tonight, though, Don, watch how they work, especially with Austin Hedges behind there. You see the four-seamer working there. But when you have a two-seamer, you're going to have to get those calls in the bottom of the strike zone, and that's what Austin Hedges does a really nice job with.
Last year had trouble with the Cubs in relief, but certainly in the starting role of the Padres thrived last year. And a good start to tonight as he strikes out Drew Robinson to begin the evening.
Well, he set him up with all kinds of success and then had the breaking ball to finish the left-hander off.
So one down here in the first inning, and it'll bring up Elvis Andrus. With the starters up the middle tonight for Texas, with Andrus at shortstop, Odor at second base. He'll chop one towards third, and Spangenberg back to grab it from foul ground. Long throw, and it's not in time. Nice try by Spangenberg down there at third base to collect it, and then he had the long throw, but beating it out is Andrus.
Well, in the spotlight is Corey Spangenberg, and you watch some of the ground balls down here in Arizona, the reaction play, and coming up, I think he just had a tough time throwing that baseball because of getting the grip. That jump took him off balance, but he made a strong throw and nice on the back end by Will Myers.
Haven't seen a good arm from him from third base, making that transition from second base to third base here during the spring. And of course, Yonhervis Solarte, and he returns tonight and is playing at second base.
Yeah, and I think you're going to see more of that, and stay tuned, because there's a lot of versatility that has been shown in this spring training with Andy Green and moving infielders from second to third and vice versa.
Well, Odor gets hit with that pitch inside. Clayton Richard gets him. So with one out now, two on all of a sudden here for the Rangers.
Well, it looked like a two-seamer just got away from him and maybe caught the jersey. I think Odor is the spring training at bat after the successful WBC. Comes back and gets brushed back.
So two on, one away. You got guys coming back from kind of major competition back to spring training type games. And I guess the mentality's a little bit different, I would think.
A little throttle back,
yeah,
a little bit when it comes down to it. Yes, the intensity of the World Baseball Classic.
Hey! Rua sharply through the right side into right field, a base hit. Andrus will be waved around. The throw from right field from Blash is headed to third, and it is off the mark. Run scores, and the Rangers take a 1-0 lead. And Rua sharply and aggressively jumping on that first pitch. Getting the base hit into right and driving in a run.
Yeah, hitting cleanup tonight and going the other way. Don't necessarily see that from the cleanup hitter early in the ballgame, in with runners in scoring position, but nice piece of hitting by Rua.
So first and third now for Texas after the leadoff strikeout by Drew Robinson. And it brings up Nomar Mazara.
Man, did Mazara come on the scene last year when he got his opportunity? It was almost a two-week audition. And he stayed up the rest of the year because of his success and his early success. I see the open stance and also the power aspect of his swing. Go down to Texas and you see that stadium. The ball travels really well, especially that right center gap.
And especially when the heat heats up.
Mm-hmm.
Well, kind of surprising. Being in spring training, we figured the Yonhervis Solarte would be at third base where he was last year. And we came down here and it'd be a battle at second between Spangenberg and Schimpf. And then things changed while he was away and he comes back and now he's at second base.
Yeah, and I think Andy Green would like to see how he functions at second base. But obviously, offensive numbers, you're going to be enhanced with the second base position. And possibly trying to take care of his legs might be something just to try to see if you can get Yonhervis Solarte to play more games.
And DeGrane was not really all that enthused with the way that he was used during the WBC, especially a guy coming off several leg injuries to be used as a pinch runner early on during the WBC. He did not really sit well.
Well, I think everything has to do with, you know, doing the right thing. If you're an organization, sending your players that they want to represent their countries, but you want your players to play. And there's nothing wrong with that. And pinch hitting opportunities were the first thing that you think like Yonhervis Solarte had to do, but also pinch running. That's not something that, I think the Padres and Andy Green expected.
Not easy to keep everybody happy, especially as talented as those rosters were.
Oh, you see, the best of the best. And I know Yonhervis had a great time, saw the big smile on his face. He's excited to be back, but what a great experience for these players to represent their country.
And settling back here into camp, about 10 days left to go here in spring training, and chance to get into several games.
You know, as we touched on, Don, it's getting at bats for certain players. Obviously, you have to throttle them back. You don't want them to play every single day. But Andy Green has the access to be able to send these players down to the minor league system and get at bats, try to get 3-4 at bats. Ryan Schimpf was down there today.
Chop to first. Meyer's going to try to start it to second for one. Back to first, going to be late, and a run will score. From third, Odor comes in, and the Rangers take a 2-0 lead. And do get Ruai at second base. 3-6 on the force out there as Lazar reaches at first base and picks up an RBI. So 2-0 Rangers here in the first inning. Runner at first, and here is Cesar Puello. Puello batting from the right side. They play for him to go the other way as Travis Jankowski into right center field. And they stay away, and he'll chase it for strike one.
You know, Don, slowly you're seeing the Texas Rangers be the example of Major League Baseball and how you're going to try to develop your players, go out there and incorporate yourself through Latin America, develop through the draft. And this organization now is built to make runs, and they've done a really nice job. I think Bannister is one of the up-and-coming managers, and obviously in his third year, already the manager of the year. Last year came in second in that award.
Runner goes, kind of a delayed steal, and the throw down there is going to be in time. A delayed steal. Mazzara taking off after the pitch was thrown, and he is thrown out to end the inning. But the Rangers get a pair, take a 2-0 lead. Have jumped on top 2-0. Andy Green's squad tonight. As we take a look at the starting lineup for him, it is Travis Jankowski leading it off in center field. Will Myers at first base with Yonhervis Solarte back, and at second base, Hunter Renfroe in left field in the cleanup spot with Austin Hedges doing the catching. Jabari Blash getting the start in right. Corey Spangenberg at third. Luis Sardinia is at short, and the pitcher, Clayton Richard, batting in the nine spot as the pitchers are starting to hit the deeper we get into spring training. A lot of DHing for the first 15 or so games here during the spring, but now the pitchers are starting to hit. And Jankowski will foul this off to the left out of play.
Well, we see Travis Jankowski be very aggressive down here as we take a look at the right-hander for the Texas Rangers, Nick Martinez. He has struggled in spring training with over a 16 ERA. See 20 hits, 15 earned runs. That's not a good spring training. Look, easy looking outside of this rotation.
Last year, 2-3 in the majors with the Rangers, an ERA over 5 in 12 appearances. Ground ball up the middle, and that'll get into right center field. Out of the reach of Odor at second base. And the speedster Jankowski continues to have a great spring. Came into tonight's game 14 for 41. That works out to be a 341 average during spring training.
Looks like a different player to me, and it's a comfort that he's had. He's showing confidence, but also just looks slower when it comes down to it. See the leg kick and really nice moss. Take a look at the moss that he's got working.
Fabulous. It is flowing. It is thick. It's fabulous.
I'm not a hair guy. You know that all the time. But man, is that nice.
I'm an envious hair guy. Pitch in there for a strike to Will Myers. This is interesting tonight. Myers batting second for the first time in the Padres order.
Yeah, I think when you talk about analytics and something that you're looking at throughout baseball, you're seeing more of this. Your best hitter in your lineup is typically hitting second. Maybe it's trying to add those at-bats throughout the course of the season. But typically, you're seeing that guy that would use the hole, try to hit in between first and second. Not anymore. Will Myers, he understands, he hits a gap. Travis Jankowski scoring fairly easily.
I guess the theory being a chance to see him up more often the higher he is in the order. And certainly there's a guy you want to see up more often if you're Andy Green.
And Will Myers has looked very comfortable in spring training. Yesterday we saw two ringing doubles. And Andy Green understands the importance of what he brings to a lineup for the Padres.
I don't want to kill you with numbers, but he's 13 for 33 during the spring. That's .394 during spring training for Will Myers.
Yeah, and the on-base percentage is skyrocketing with 9 walks to go along with those hits.
And as we've talked about, he's got to certainly learn to take the walk when he can, because you look at this Padres lineup, when you face them during the season, the one guy you're not going to let beat you is this guy. So he may not get a lot of good pitchers to hit.
Yeah, it's going to be on the shoulders of Yonhair Vasilarte, who's hitting behind him tonight. Also Hunter Renfro and others that have to hit behind Will Myers.
There's Solarte waiting on deck. Padres batting here in the home half of the first inning. And another check at first base. And back to the bag is Jankowski.
And not a bad time to run, too. 2-2 count. You're probably thinking that they might work a breaking ball here.
Fouled back and out of play. We'll do it again, 2-2.
You think about so many reasons why you would have Will Myers hitting second, the speed of Jankowski getting on. He's probably going to buy him a little more fastballs when it comes down to it because of respecting the speed of Travis Jankowski.
Now the whole key is getting Jankowski on, and he's been able to get on during the spring, and it's also been amazing what he's done against lefties during the course of the spring, something he worked on hard during the winter. Well, check swing foul here, and this time Jankowski was off. Now defensively in behind Nick Martinez tonight for the Texas Rangers. Drew Robinson is out in left field. Cesar Puello is in center field. Nomar Mazara in right. It is Doug Bernier at third base. Elvis Andrews at short. Rougned Odor at second. James Loney at first base. And the catcher is Brett Hayes for Nick Martinez. Martinez with a 2-2 pitch. And the breaking ball misses inside. Playing under the lights tonight here for
I love it. A
rare spring training night game.
You know, the tough thing is that you're so accustomed to getting up early in the morning. So it's very difficult to sleep in for these players. They're accustomed to those early mornings down here in spring training. But you have to be able to be acclimated to night games. And you're seeing a lot of clubs that probably put in 5, maybe 6 night games on the schedule.
Off is Jankowski, and another foul by Myers, and a good at bat here. Yeah, the morning usually beginning, what, around 6 a.m.?
Oh, yeah.
Getting here and Clubhouse opens up around 7:30. I mean, it is early every day.
You know what the toughest part is? And obviously the coaching staff, and they put many hours into it because it's developing these guys, getting them ready. The trainers, the athletic trainers, yeah. They get here before, and also the clubhouse guys,
absolutely.
Spencer Dallin and his staff.
Swing and a miss, and a snap throw down to first base, and Jankowski is back safely. Well, Myers finally strikes out. Martinez gets him for the first out here in the bottom of the first inning.
You see the fastball that's elevated, gets over the barrel. And Brett Hayes tries to get Travis Jankowski. He didn't get a jump, so he jacks on the brakes and slides in just in front of James Loney's tag.
One out, and Jankowski will gain his lead at first base. And Hervis Solarte has returned to the Padres, and doing so after being in the WBC representing Venezuela. Check on first base again, and Jankowski back to the bag. Martinez has been very concerned with Jankowski, and you really have to be.
Yeah, and when your thoughts are on the runner, that's the mistake. So Yonhervis Solarte looking for that fastball early in the count.
Runner goes, and the pitch is strike, high throw, and Jankowski is safe at second base. Head first slide. And the stolen base for Jankowski.
Well, speed impacts the game, and Travis Jankowski, see that runner's lean? Easily sliding head first into second base. Putting pressure on the defense, but also getting in scoring position, scoring runs as a leadoff hitter.
So one down, Jankowski gaining his lead at second base. And Solarte's liner is caught. It'll turn into a double play. Got a bit of a shift on, and Elvis Andrews was in exactly the right spot. Turns into two. It is 2-0 Texas after one.
Is spot on. He's able to read hitters, go through with Darren Balsley and go through the scouting report and understand how this pitcher's strength lines up with a hitter's weakness and then how to make adjustments in game. And defensively as a catcher, I think he's going to be as good as anyone in the game.
High praise for the young backstop when it comes to Austin Hedges. He's putting in the work. He understands this is his job. And he looks very comfortable behind the plate.
Off the bat of Puelo, it's Spangenberg. It fires across in time to get him. First out of the second inning. That's very high praise for Austin Hedges.
Well, in being around Austin, he knows he's putting in the work, and he grinds with the pitcher. I think that's his strength when it comes down to it. Austin understands the importance of this pitching staff being able to get the most out of your starters, and with that lead, lock it down with the successful relievers. I think that's what it comes down to it. But putting that video work in and being able to go over the scouting reports, it's essential. And you don't usually see that from a young catcher. You're usually learning that.
And Clayton Richard getting the first out here of the second inning. And here is veteran James Loney. Loney well-traveled, of course, originally a Dodger. With his size, I think people expected more home runs from James Loney. He just didn't have the power. He's always a good hitter.
Yeah, played with James when he came up with the Los Angeles Dodgers and has power, but it was during batting practice and implementing the batting practice homer to the game speed. And a lot of changes when it came down to James Loney that he did with the Dodgers. He'd go into the cages, feel very comfortable during batting practice. You see a different stance coming into the game, and you wonder where he was mentally. But the power didn't really transfer during the games.
Most home runs ever had in the season was 15, and that was as a member of the Dodgers back in 2007.
Well, I think it's the commitment of what you want to be and identify yourself as a hitter. Are you a power hitter, or can you hit the ball and spray the ball all over the place? The Mark Grace type. The career of James Loney with 108 home runs on his career.
Had a great season a couple of years back, getting right around 300 and over it for most of the year as a member of the Tampa Bay Rays in 2013. He did finish the year playing in 158 games and hit 299 that year for Tampa Bay in one of three seasons in a Rays uniform. And was last year in the Padres organization, played 43 games at AAA for El Paso, but never did get up to San Diego. Ended up with the Mets. And he strikes out here. Second strikeout for Richard, two down.
Well, we just saw the strikeout. You're going to have to handle the low part of the strike zone and how Austin Hedges does it. We go back to the previous hitter and working it on his one knee to really work up into the strike zone on that bottom part. Austin Hedges understands the importance with the sinker baller that you have to stick that, get that thumb underneath the baseball.
Hayes will chop this foul outside of third. That seemed like last year really made a big difference in the development of Austin Hedges.
Yeah, and you think about El Paso, it's known for the offense, and what did everyone talk about with Austin Hedges? Is his offense going to catch up to his defensive abilities? Well, last year, being in AAA, he had success.
Chopped up the middle as Sardinez will range around second, off balance and in time. Nice play by Luis Sardinez. The shortstop, Clayton Richard, has a 1-2-3 inning. It's 2-0 Texas. 2-0. Rangers have the lead. We'll see Hunter Renfro lead it off here for the Padres. And yesterday coming up with a big home run.
Well, this is a bomb. Elevated fastball, and he deposits in the left field. Starting to see Hunter Renfro heat up with those mistakes. The power's in there. Spring training, he's had a lot of thoughts to go in his mind. Obviously, defensively, he wants to make a priority, but the bat is real with the power.
Renfro hitting at 304 during the spring, 14 for 46. Two home runs, seven runs batted in. And tonight getting the start in left field. We have seen him primarily in right field, both last year in the major leagues and pretty much all spring.
Yeah, they like to see Jabari Blash, who is also up for a roster spot as well, playing right field.
Renfro's got a great arm, which has always made him a good choice for right field.
Yeah, they like to make him an all-around player and mechanically be aware of what he's doing with that strong arm. Also being able to improve on his jumps, which you're always trying to work on as an outfielder. Now we saw last year the NL Player of the Week, the last week of the season, and he put on a show, including that big bomb in the Western Metal Supply Company building.
To third, a tough hop, but Bernier is there and spins and fires in time to get Renfro. Nice play. Bernier able to move to his left that time and fire to first. Renfro retired, and that's the first out here at the bottom of the second inning. Austin Hedges coming up. Another guy hitting at 300 over spring training, 9 for 24 so far out of the gate, and been up over 300.
Now we touched on his success last year at AAA El Paso. I think it goes a long way, no matter where you are. And obviously people say, yeah, it's a great hitter's ballpark, it's a great hitter's league. You still have to perform, and confidence has a lot to do with it. Austin Hedges looks very different to me in a batter's box. He looks comfortable at times. We saw in a couple years ago when he's up in the big leagues for a long time, got pull conscious. He has worked diligently with Alan Zinter, the hitting coach, on just his approach and staying behind the baseball.
Yeah, you can understand if he got a little frustrated last year based on the amount of major league time that he had the year before. 56 total games in 2015 in the major leagues, mm-hmm, with the Padres. And last year, spending the bulk of the year at AAA El Paso, only 8 games for the Padres in the major leagues, and that came after the championship for the Chihuahuas.
Yeah, and I think that had a lot to do with it, too, in developing the younger players in AAA, but also they went through a great experience winning that championship, and Austin had a lot to do with that. You're wondering how they develop each individual, but collectively, that wave of players that we saw in September, that's a good sign for the Padres organization.
In the air to left field, Robinson had started back, now in. And he'll take care of out number two. So a ground out and a fly out, and there are two outs here in the second inning. Brings up Jabari Blash. He's had a very good spring training so far. Numbers for Blash, 5 home runs. He's driven in 13 and 8 walks jumps out at me for, yeah, Jabari Blash during the spring.
Stays in the strike zone very well, knows that.
High drive, right field, opposite way. Mazzara going back onto the track to make the catch in front of the wall. So Blash sends it to deep right field, but didn't get enough the other way. 1-2-3 go the Padres. It's 2-0 Texas. nothing. Rangers on top as they come to bat here in the visiting half of the third inning. And Clayton Richard back on the mound again. Gave up two runs in the first. Enjoyed a 1-2-3 second inning. Two ground outs and a strikeout. Bernier is the batter, and a late cut on a fastball running away.
Well, how we're going to look at Clayton Richard and the success he's having now. Now you're starting to see that intensity pick up a little bit, but also the ground balls. That's very important. The last inning induced two ground ball outs. He's also trying to change that eye level, which I think was something that was incorporated early in his starts in spring training, with that four-seamer to be able to pitch at the top of the strike zone.
And four ground ball out so far in the night, and this one running inside on him, 1-2. Bernier leading it off. Robinson and Andrus scheduled to bat in the inning. And a liner caught at shortstop by Sardinas.
Dawn It's Coming, opening series presented by Saquon Casino, is April 7th through the ninth against the San Francisco Giants. Tickets on to opening day include a free opening day t-shirt. Don't miss the festivities of opening series weekend. Tickets are at Padres.com.
Can't wait.
I can't either. Bruce Bochy and his Giants coming in. They're picked as the favorite of the division by a lot of people. Obviously, we see the Dodgers before that series up in Los Angeles. The test is there right in front of the Padres.
Is there some sort of rule that the Padres have to open up with the L.A. Dodgers and Clayton Kershaw every year?
Yeah, you see that a lot, don't you?
It's amazing.
Well, they're going to be tested with pretty much their whole staff with the four games up in Los Angeles before three in San Diego against the San Francisco Giants.
Ball and a strike here to Robinson. And he'll foul it off down by the shoe tops, 1-2.
So you know what that means. Probably going to see Madison Bumgarner and probably Johnny Cueto on that weekend series.
Great.
Good luck to you.
The Padres hitters are excited.
Oh, that how can they
news?
Not?
Yeah.
There's a fight at the bat rack.
Sharply hit and guarding the line nicely was Will Myers. He'll take it to the bag for out number two of the inning. That's six in a row retired by Richard, getting some help from his friends.
Well, he had to fight this. This is a hot smash, and you can see the hard hops down here in Arizona. Will Myers continues to get better and better. We always emphasize his offense, but his defense and his comfort over at first base.
I am noticing that as long as spring training goes on and as hot as it is here, the sun peltering down onto the field, how hard surface has gotten.
Yeah, and you know that. It's going to the spike marks. You got to watch out. But, yes, the fields aren't like that in here in Arizona compared to the one in San Diego.
Elvis Andrus sending one out to center field on a line. He's 2-for-2 on the night. And that breaks up a string of six in a row, retired by Clayton Richard.
Well, Elvis Andrus offensively has to chip in. This is a dynamic offense for Jeff Banister and the Rangers. Putting his piece in with a nice piece of hitting, working the center of the diamond.
So two down, Andrus at first base, and it brings up Rougned Odor, who was hit by a pitch. Odor would score the second Rangers run back in the first inning.
With two outs, you got to be careful. That's the reason why. And it's going to be interesting. We've touched on this with Will Myers working off the base, holding that runner. And with Clayton Richard, known for a good move. Sometimes you're going to get picked off as a first baseman when it comes to a good move like Clayton Richard.
Richard had the only pickoff for a Padres pitcher last season. He's coming over there again. Yeah, how different is it for a pitcher to throw over in the direction of a guy who's not standing on the bag? You kind of change a little bit.
Something you have to work on, and it comes down to it where they're going to have to be comfortable with Will Myers. But this is when it accentuates how hard it is for both the first baseman and the pitcher. But you're in a better position to catch the baseball. So that good pickoff move or the bad throw, you're able to be more versatile to be able to catch that ball rather than running into the runner and exposing that guy to even advance a base, maybe two.
Line to first and Myers on the backhand will make the play that ends the inning. We will come back and the manager, the Padres, will be alongside. It's 2-0, Texas. Padres, we head to the bottom of the third, and as promised, the manager of the Padres, Andy Green, joins us. And Andy, how are things going so far here during spring? I have a little trouble with Andy Green's mic right now. His first pitch of the inning is carved foul by Spangenberg.
You guys hear me up there?
Yeah, we hear you now.
Hey, finally alive. My wife tunes me out, too, a lot of times. I thought you guys were already doing that to me.
Well, no, we wouldn't do that
to
you.
We would never do that.
Well, Andy, you discussed what's happening in spring training for you, and now you start getting into that mode of you start smelling that opening day, and it's coming closer. How is it to manage these games? Is it going to be changing for you?
It'll start to change here pretty soon. The status quo, getting young guys in late in games right now and giving them some opportunity. I think we're seeing our guys on the field more consistently right now in starting lineups, and that's exciting. You start to get a feel of what your club really is. Early in spring, you got a bunch of young guys finishing off ball games that probably aren't going to be on your club. So we get a better sense of what we got as a club here soon.
And that's one of the things certainly about spring training. You hope to come out of it healthy, and you think about what spring training is for, and you hope health is going to be on your side. So far, so good, but you do have some guys that are banged up.
Yeah, we've been banged. I think the loss of Alex Dickerson was hard for us early in spring training. He's a big part of what we're going to do this season. He'll be back at some point in time. But outside of him, most every other injury we've had has kind of been a nick or a scrape here or there. And all those guys are going to be back before the start of the season. So I think all in all, it's been a relatively healthy spring training. And looking forward to getting Margot back on the field here in a couple days and Ryan Schimpf on the field tomorrow. So we're getting closer to full strength.
Andy, continuing to focus on the position players, you get back Yonhair Vasilarte. And you signed him to a new deal, getting him back from the WBC. What's that mean to the club?
He's the life of the club, man. He's a ton of fun on the baseball field. You saw him in the three-hole today. Already smoked a line drive, turned into a double play on us. But that was actually one of the better base-running double plays we've had this spring. We've had some issues on the base paths we got to clean up before the season starts. But Soli's a big part of this club. He's the heart and soul of it. And to get him back on the field and in camp, I think everybody just feeds off his energy.
Well, what went behind some of the thought process maybe of putting him at second base, which we see him tonight?
Yeah, I think Spangy and Schimpf both look really good at third base. I got to look at Schimpf late last year. I've been looking at Spangy over there all season. When I was coaching third in Arizona, I got a good feel for what Spangy was at third base, and I think he's a plus defensive third baseman. I think Soli probably turns a double play better than the rest of them, and you know, we're not committed to this lineup at this point in time, but we are committed to getting a look at it and seeing how well it plays out, and I kind of like the look of it tonight, but we'll let it play out over the next couple weeks.
Andy, let's shift to the pitching side of it. Obviously, I think the strength of this club, and I think a lot of Padre fans know the importance of shortening a game, and that the relief corps is very good. Now sorting out the starting rotation, I think you have three slots. It sounds like they're locked up a little bit. How about the rest of the rotation?
Yeah, I think the back end of our rotation coming to focus here in the next 2 weeks, obviously. But Jared Cozart's been really good in camp. I think he's taken some dramatic steps forward. And it's good to see him with that bone spur removed. It looks free and easy. It's out in front. The velo's about the same as it was last year, but his ability to finish and extend looks good. He's in the strike zone a lot more. And I feel good about the way he's looked right now. And, you know, Luis Perdomo's been who Luis Perdomo is. And, you know, Trevor Cahill's shown flashes. His last game wasn't great, but he's looked good. And, you know, we get Christian Friedrich back on the mound and healthy. He's a little nicked up right now. You know, he threw the ball pretty well for us last year. So those four guys are kind of fighting for those last couple of spots in the rotation. And that'll probably be decided here towards the end of camp.
You know, Andy, I think you always look forward in where this team's going to be later in this spring training, starting the season, but you look back at what Luis Perdomo did. Were you surprised at last year's success?
You know, we knew he had talent. Our scouts did an unbelievable job of identifying him in the Rule 5 draft and focused in on him early. We saw him in San Diego at a mini camp in the offseason, and you immediately saw what he was. And, you know, he was the young, shell-shocked guy in opening day against the Dodgers, and by the end of the year, he's throwing a complete game. I probably should go out there and argue right now, guys. What do you think? Yes. You got a replay on that? Should I tell him to put the headset on?
Take my headset
off and put it on Adrian behind home plate right now? I think that would fly very well.
No, it probably wouldn't, but I think you have a gripe if we take a look at the replay. And Corey Spangenberg, Travis Jankowski setting the tone for the offense and high tag and look like he got in there.
Yeah, but I think he's safe, Andy. You may want to go out right now.
You want me to go right now? Yeah. Just sprint out there, spring training, go after him.
Yeah, that'd be fun.
For you guys, probably not for me when I got a letter or a call from Joe Torre at the end of the day, but I'm glad you'd enjoy it. It's for your amusement.
Do you have a little Bobby Cox in you or possibly the Billy Martin?
Probably not the spring training headset on right now. I don't think my leash is long enough. If I look at this, I don't think I can make it all the way out there.
Now one out in the inning. Luis Sardinia is batting, and manager Andy Green with us. And Andy had to make a tough decision as far as the release today of Paul Clemens, a guy that participated last year, and a tough situation, I'm sure, to have to release anybody.
You know, the cut days are never fun. We sent 10 guys out today, 9 down to the minor leagues, and we released Paul. And Paul Clemens is a classic human being. He is a good person, and we loved having him in the organization, and it gave him a leash and an opportunity last year to earn a spot this year. And spring hadn't gone the way he'd hoped for it to go, and you know, sometimes it's the kindest thing to do to a guy instead of dragging it out over the last 13 days if his odds of making the team are really slim, to let him have that opportunity to go find a job elsewhere. And that's what we chose to do this morning with him. And tough conversations, not fun days, but I think the world of that guy and his family, and wish him nothing but the best.
My last question has to do with what we saw last inning from Will Myers, and something we've seen all spring, him play off the bag and holding a runner on, and your thoughts with that, and something you think may stick during the regular season.
Yeah, it's another unique look we're looking at in spring training. We had struggles with Will applying tags last season. We worked on it quite a bit, and I think we picked one person off all season. A lot of that has to do with his tendency to reach out and catch the baseball instead of letting it travel to him, and also his lack of willingness to drive a tag onto a guy.
This is driven pretty well, but caught by Puelo out on the warning track for out number 2.
So we tried to put Will in a different position, more or less, to give him an opportunity to tag a little bit differently. Also gets him off the base a little bit quicker so he doesn't have to shuffle off the base. Haven't quite seen any fruits from it this far in spring, but we'll continue to let it play out over the next week or so and see if he can drive some tags onto guys from that position. It does limit the number of throws that we can tag with. They have to be on the kind of left hip for him to even apply a tag right now. So we're giving up something to potentially get something, but when you only picked one guy off last season, you're not really risking much trying to change.
Lastly, from a personal standpoint, how different is it for you coming into spring training this year after managing all of last year?
It's quite a bit different. Not so much necessarily for me and the way I feel in relation to the team, but just the dramatic composition change of this ball club. Last year, we got a dad catching it with one handed holding onto the kid with the other over there.
I think so.
Got some skills in the stands. For me, the big difference is we had veterans last year. We're a young ball club this year, but we're going to grow and we're going to do some special things before it's all said and done.
Andy Green, thanks much. We're looking forward to it.
Thanks, guys.
Andy Green, the manager of the Padres, joining us. Texas on top here, 2-0 after 3.
City of Peoria, Arizona. And MLB.tv Premium is back and better than ever. Watch every out-of-market regular season game live on over 400 supported devices. Plus, enjoy almost 300 spring training games in the 2017 World Baseball Classic. Blackout and other restrictions apply. Visit MLB.tv for details.
Fourth inning, 2-0. Texas on top, and back on the mound is Clayton Richard. Juan Mazara and Pueyo to bat in the inning. And Richard giving up the two runs to the Rangers in the first inning. Since then has been very good. And one more ground ball outs for Clayton Richard as his outing has progressed. At one point had retired six batters in a row.
Don, we talked about the success he had as a starter last year and the ground ball rate, over 64%. With ground balls, and the reason why he dropped his arm down, almost a three-quarter action, but when you get on top of that baseball, it has a lot of action in the hitting zone, so it enables these hitters to think they're going to square the ball up, but they're hitting the top part of the ball.
This is the third off the glove of Spangenberg, but Sardinias gets it, and his throw will be late, but a nice bid left side of the Padres infield, and a pick at first base by Myers, but it takes too long. Lead runner on here for the Rangers. Second hit for Rua. So we thank Andy Green for joining us last inning. And last year, you have to think about the job that he did last year with all the different players and roster moves that took place last season. And as he said, started the year with such a veteran squad, but by year's end, it was anything but veterans.
Yeah, and developing at the big league level, that's not something you'd necessarily sign up for. But Andy Green, I think it's slowed down a little bit, the process of going through your first spring training, your first year in the big leagues. Andy's been around this game and knows how to manage people. When it comes down to Andy's strengths, that communication that he has with his whole roster, including guys that got sent down today, and they're going to be helping the club. He is very straightforward when it comes to what he expects at the big league level.
A lot of tough conversations taking place right around now in spring training, and had a lot of them today, including the releasing of Paul Clemens, who started games last year for the Padres, was starting games here during the spring.
Yeah, and we saw Paul, too. He was excellent with us, always a great soundbite when it came to Paul, and also the some of the things that he did on the mound. I appreciate it. It put a smile to your face, yeah. But I think it was really important for him to Andy to say they're giving Paul Clemens an opportunity to not only, yes, you're getting released and that's disappointing, but time to be able to latch on to another organization and possibly help them.
And that's a key, because there are a lot of organizations right now trying to make those tough decisions and may need some guys, and it's fair to him to really let him loose if he's not going to be part of your plans and they were aware he was not.
Yeah, some people might say, well, why didn't they wait? Because you never know with injuries, the surplus. They're focused on the guys that they really believe are going to make this roster. They have the people that are in the minor leagues that can take those opportunities. That's the reason why you come up with an organizational saying that we have to release him now. But I think it's the right thing to do, and it's a classy way, because it doesn't happen to you. To your point, it doesn't happen all the time.
And a lot of guys sent out to AAA today as well, as the camp size dwindles in the last 10 days or so of camp, when they started at 68 players in camp. And now that number has been reduced to quite a bit today, 10 guys being sent out today.
Yeah, and Hervis Solarte coming. Right. Carlos Asuaje gets sent down, and he showed well. But there's things to work on. And those communication skills that I talked about with Andy Green, those are some of the things you have in the meeting. It's not just saying, hey, you're going down to the minor leagues. Just get it done. They go over some of the strengths and weaknesses that they have to work on in the minor leagues to get up here and perform better.
And in some cases, giving them the plan that has them coming back at some point, too. You don't want to make any promises, but here's what could happen.
Well, that's the mystery, as from the player's perspective, going down and saying, am I going to get back up there? Because mentally, that is challenging, because you were right in front of the managers, the whole coaching staff, trying to make an impression. Now you get sent down to the minor leagues. How you regroup from that emotional high when you're at the big league level?
Ball four, inside to Pueyo, and he's down to first base. A walk and two on here for the Rangers with one down in the fourth inning. Yeah, the atmosphere in spring training is different anyway here for the major league games. But then when you end up on a backfield tomorrow in double A or triple A, I mean, it is 100% different.
Well, that changes, and I think it's a good change if you think of if you're a Padre fan and you're wondering what's next. I've been on those backfields this year. It's different. There's a lot of talent out there, and there's a lot of competition. I think that makes everyone that has to go down understand they have to perform, because someone else is going to jump over you. In years past, that wasn't the case in the minor leagues.
But there is so much talent, especially in the lower minors, and those guys are coming.
Yeah, they are. And they're not afraid to advance if you earned it. So I think a lot of these players understand that if I can get to that next level, whether it's single A to high single A or single A to double A, that big jump, the Padres and their brass aren't worried about sending those guys up to the big league level in producing themselves and jumping those different levels so they get an opportunity here.
I saw a lot of those guys in the Futures game at Petco Park in October last year, and they'll be heading out to low A, high A in some cases, and on the way, part of the waves of talent coming to the San Diego Padres in the very near future. Runner at second takes off, ball gets away, and now the runner at first can take off for second. Pueyo will get to second base, and it's second and third on the wild pitch. A stolen base mixed in there, too.
I see this pitch in the bottom part, and I think Austin Hedges wanted to throw this before he received it. That's what makes it challenging when you have so much movement on your pitches.
So a stolen base, getting Rue out of third and Pueyo to second on a wild pitch, and putting Richard in a jam here. Second and third, one out. And James Loney ahead in the count, 2-1. Loney struck out swinging his first time up in the second inning. One of three Ks for Richard.
defensively pinched in on the corners up the middle.
And grounded to Myers on the backhand, looks the runner back and then flips to Richard covering the bag for the out. Nicely done having the corners in work there. And a good job by Clayton Richard getting over there to cover the bag at first for out number two of the inning.
Now, first of all, inducing the ground ball and executing your pitch for Clayton Richard. Second and third, that's very difficult pitching at the top of the zone. But you can see pinched on the corners, and Will Myers, this is where he slows the game down, looking that runner back to third base and easily flipping it to Clayton Richard for the out. Big out.
So two down, second and third, and Brett Hayes coming up here for the Rangers. Hayes grounded out to shortstop in the second inning, 0 for 1. The catching tonight for Texas. And a chance here to add to the Rangers' lead on top 2-0.
Well, from the Rangers' perspective, trying to get Jonathan Lucroy back will be huge. He's involved with the United States with the WBC, the World Baseball Classic. What a pickup that was at the trading deadline for the Rangers.
Chop left side, and it's cut off by Spangenberg, who fires to first for the out that ends the inning, and Richard out of the jam. 3.5 done, 2-0 Texas.
The Texas Rangers lead the Padres 2-0. And every weekday morning, Skip Bayless and Shannon Sharp go head-to-head on the day's hottest sports topics, easy for me to say. Undisputed with Skip and Shannon weekdays from 6:30 a.m. to 9 a.m. Pacific, only on FS1. Undisputed.
Dogs in the house, some big dogs. That's a big dog right there. Hanging out on the berm here.
How about the little guy right on top?
he looks afraid, doesn't he?
Yeah.
It's like, you really don't want to be hanging out with this other really big dog. And there's another big dog over there.
He's a good boy right there. Get some water. Yeah.
And I'm a little dog, and I'm scared.
You're our San Diego poodle.
Last of the fourth inning, Travis Jankowski as the only Padres hit in the night.
Two.
Travis not crazy about that call. Mark Sweeney not crazy about that call.
Sorry, Adrian. Looked a little down.
Now he's down 0-2.
Well, Martinez looks very comfortable now working that changeup off the first pitch fastball. He's settled in nicely.
Guy who's had a rough spring training and kind of pitched his way out of the starting rotation possibility for the Rangers to this point, but he'll be opening some eyes tonight.
Well, 15 earned runs he's given up in four outings.
He injured right now for the Rangers, but a couple guys that the Padres are very familiar with. Two guys in the rotation last year, and Andrew Kashner and Tyson Ross, both Texas Rangers now.
Yeah, and you see the trying to bolster their staff. I think when you think of the Texas Rangers, obviously Yu Darvish, Cole Hamels comes to mind.
Swing and a miss, and Jankowski strikes out. Third K for Martinez. Here are the changes, key additions for them, and the subtractions from last year. And kind of surprised Mike Napoli didn't end up back with the Cleveland Indians as a part of the team last year that really surprised everybody and went the distance.
Yeah, third time's the charm for Mike Napoli. This is the third time in the Texas Rangers organization, but that he's well known for being a guy that's the glue to the club. Obviously playing first base. Mitch Moreland goes to the Red Sox, and that was a void that really had to be filled.
A chance of Napo Lee will be going through the ballpark in Arlington. Bat hand coming off the bat. Top hand for Will Myers on that cut.
I am pretty surprised that Napoli's not back in Cleveland. The success that they had, they go with Edwin Encarnacion to try to add to that offense.
He's coming off a very big year. And, of course, a guy who has success in the postseason. And to me, that means a lot.
Yeah, you're seeing more of that now with teams that have had success in years past, and they continue to add to their roster.
30 home runs, over 100 RBIs, 34 home runs to be exact, and 101 RBIs for Napoli as Myers grounds out for the second out of the inning. Now third time that he'll be in Texas. He's there in 2012. Of course, won a World Series with Red Sox in 2013. And back with Texas for part of 2015 before going to Cleveland last year.
Yeah, I don't think he gets a lot of credit, too, for the way he plays first base.
This is into center field, and over is Pueyo. Here's a base hit for Yanhervis Solarte. Breaks up a string of four in a row, retired by Martinez. Two-out base hit. Solarte challenging like he may take second base, but he remains at first.
Well, Solarte, two line drives tonight. One was caught for a double play in the first inning, but again, working the middle of the field. This is on the breaking ball. Good to see Yanhervis back, getting some at-bats.
It does not appear playing second base is bothering him at all, returning here to the Padres.
You know, the challenge, and you can talk to middle infielders, infield coaches. I think the challenge for playing at second base is the back to the runner when you're turning a double play. I think the fearlessness, the way Yanhervis Solarte plays the game, I think he fits perfectly when it comes to second base. Now, that being said, we've seen Andy Green be very versatile with this roster. Doesn't mean you're not going to see Yanhervis at third.
And it sounds like we're still going to see Spangenberg see some outfield reps before the end of spring training, too.
Well, he touched on Alex Dickerson, and that injury changed a lot of things around this camp. The need for Alex Dickerson, the way he powered the baseball from the left side. That injury sounds like it's going to take him into the beginning of the season. So opportunity awaits in left field.
Foul tipped, and it's 1-2. Hunter Renfro getting his second look at Nick Martinez tonight. Renfro grounded out to third base in the second inning. And batting here in the fourth with two outs and Solarte at first base. In the air to left field. Robinson coming in. And he'll take care of out number three to end the fourth inning. It's on to the fifth with the Rangers on top 2-0.
Arizona. And did you know Padre membership starts at 10 games and you can pick the games you want? By becoming a Padres member, you save up to 10% off the single game ticket price and you can earn additional membership benefits. Visit Padres.com/comepadres for more info.
Fifth inning, Rangers on top 2-0. Benny here leading it off here for the Rangers. Robinson and Andrus scheduled to bat here in the fifth inning. Cooled off here a little bit tonight, if you call 87 degrees cooling off.
Well, it was hot today.
Today was the hottest day.
I felt like I was on the surface of the sun. It's a dry heat.
Yeah, sure.
It's hot.
It's hot. Good crowd on hand here tonight out on the berm enjoying the evening in the grass out there in left center and right center field here at Peoria Stadium. Plenty of dogs. We heard all kinds of barking going on early before the game, and we wonder where it's coming from.
Dog days of spring.
Now it's a center field, and that's going to fall in for a base hit. Grenier will remain at first as getting it back in is Jankowski, a leadoff single to begin things here in the fifth inning. Top of the order coming up here, and Drew Robinson with a runner at first. There's Bert Wallace, who has taken over at first base for Will Myers. His night is over. And Wallace now at first base.
That was interesting to hear what Andy Green had to say about how Will is going to position himself at first base. See Brett Wallace, and he is off the base, but not in the same position as Will Myers. He didn't think it was about the tags, but he made a good point. It's only one pickoff all year long. So putting him in a better, in a comfortable position defensively is probably more important. They haven't seen the benefit of that, but over 162 games, I think you're going to see that. Remember way back when John Olerud was with the Mets, and they had him do that. But you take the lead off, and with John Olerud being a big guy, you'd have to peek around him on the lead. So it may be uncomfortable. And then you take a jab step to the bag, it would make you take a jab step as a runner. So not putting you in an aggressive position as a base runner might be a benefit as well.
Runner goes, line out to short. Sardinias will tag him and turn this into two. And Sardinias is down to how many outs there were. He thought that was the third out of the inning. So still got another out to get.
Listen, the sleep patterns are not the same, so it changes everything. Now that's when it indicates, as a guy in the dugout, have fun with him. It's happened to all of us.
He was headed in, got the double play, and wrap it up. But in this game, you need three outs.
Yes, you do.
So one to go.
Even happens to announcers as well.
Absolutely. This is spring training for announcers also.
Yes, it is. That's why I lead the league in reads.
I noticed they have loaded up on reads for you tonight.
I wonder why.
It felt like the first part of the spring. You didn't get enough?
No.
And this being your last spring training telecast, they wanted to make sure that you got enough reps before the regular season.
My family gets me back.
It's awesome.
It's going to be great. I'll introduce them to myself tomorrow. Now, this is fun. I love it. And I love the energy and knowing that you're so close to opening day. And opening day to any player, and of course you, Don, knowing the importance of what that means. And how excited baseball fans are across the country. I can't wait.
On the ground to short, Sardinias now knows that he needs a third down, and he'll take care of it himself on the assist. That ends the top of the fifth. It's 2-0 Texas. And Mark Sweeney, Michelle Margot with you tonight from Peoria. Spring training baseball for the San Diego Padres. About 10 days left to go during the spring. And here is Austin Hedges leading it off here in the bottom of the fifth inning with Texas on top 2-0. And Grasscutter down to first base. And James Loney will tag the bag himself for the first out here in the bottom of the fifth inning.
Drop a grass cutter.
I like grass cutter.
I yeah. love that.
You know, that was really close to the grass. It's a grass cutter.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, I mixed that in. You got to get some new stuff this year. I didn't send out all my bag of tricks last year. I held some.
I really like those. Those are very witty.
Thanks. I really don't have much more. That's really. Here is Jabari Blash.
But you had a snort there.
I
heard
did.
It. I heard it coming.
You will get that on occasion. Jabari Blash fly it out to right field. Opposite field fly out his first time up and to the warning track. Boy, Martinez has looked good tonight.
You know, especially after the first inning where he looked uncomfortable at times. Got away with it with the line drive with Solarte. But he has settled in very nicely.
On the ground to the backhanded third, knocked down by Bernier. He will throw to first, low, but dug out by Loney. And Loney, a very good defensive first baseman. We were talking about guys that can pick it at first. Loney certainly can.
Very comfortable around the bag, especially with those short hops. You see third baseman knock it down, but plenty of time to get Jabari Blash. And on the back end, James Loney picking him up.
Two down here in the fifth inning brings up Cordy Spangenberg, his second plate appearance. Lifted down the left field line. Robinson on the run, falling fast and falling foul. Harmlessly jumping up into the seats. Spangenberg coming on back. He walked his first time up in the third inning. The only walk given up by Nick Martinez so far in 4 2/3 innings. Benjberg appears to have the arm for third base.
Yeah, that's surprising too, because you don't see that at second base, maybe on a turn. But we've seen him show off his arm strength, especially in this last week. I think that has a lot to do with the comfort that Andy Green speaks about at third base.
On the ground down to first, Loney's got it himself again, and he'll tag the bag to end the inning. Three ground ball outs in order for Nick Martinez, 2-0 Texas.
California burritos. It's one of my favorite things I've ever had. I really like a California burrito, but I just like my authentic Mexican food in North Carolina. It is what it is.
Well, you missed it before the game, and you think about what Will Myers and the California burrito mean to him, then check out the 2017 Padres season preview coming up after the game on Fox Sports San Diego.
It's on to the sixth inning, and that is a night for Clayton Richard, who went the first five innings of this contest. Richard giving up five hits and two runs, and Miguel Diaz now into the game for San Diego.
Rule 5 pick for the San Diego Padres, and the importance of him showing now. The first impression has already been done. Prized right arm, and he is going to have a very good opportunity making this roster. Possibly as a long man. Most of these guys in the minor leagues have been starters, log some innings, and he adds versatility to this bullpen.
Albert Martinez has taken over in right field for the Padres as well. Jabari Blash done for the night. Rougned Odor to lead it off here for Texas in the sixth inning. Odor was hit by a pitch in the first inning and scored the second Rangers run. And he lined out to Will Myers at first base in the third. So Clayton Richard tonight, 66 pitches thrown, 42 for strikes.
Well, the ground ball came into play tonight, and Clayton Richard continues to work in the bullpen and building up that stamina.
Grounder right to the shortstop, Sardinez, right around the bag at second for the first out of the inning. Yeah, we see a lot of that during spring training. If we don't get enough pitches in the start, they'll go to the pen and work some more.
Yeah, because you got to get innings. Obviously, Diaz takes over for Clayton Richard, but continuing to work. Ronswell Patrick, the AAA pitching coach down in the bullpen, always keeping eyes on what those keys are for Clayton. But a good night tonight, especially working out of some jams.
Look at the line for him tonight also. A lot of ground ball outs, always a good sign.
You look at it.
This one fouled off down the right field line, out of play. I found it interesting. I guess you didn't.
Oh, I'm looking at it right
there
now.
There it is.
It's really good.
Yeah.
But we did. We saw the two-seamer, but also the four-seamer at the top of the zone. Saw some breaking balls to go along with it. Clayton looked very comfortable. You know, early in the spring, he had a couple outings that were suspect, but I think he was looking to work on some elements of his game to add to it as Diaz punches out the second hitter.
Is the first K for Diaz and the second out of this sixth inning.
Oh, this prized arm, and you can see him reaching back and the movement on the outside part of the zone.
Good downward plane right there.
You understand why he's getting that opportunity as a Rule 5 pick, plucked from another organization, getting an opportunity to not only make it to the big leagues, but a Rule 5 pick has to stay in the big leagues for the rest of the year.
It's like Luis Perdomo did a year ago for the Padres. Breaks off a breaking ball right there to Mazzara. 0-4-2 in the game. He's grounded into a fielder's choice and struck out swinging. Line to right, Martinez just into the game, makes the running catch over towards the line. And a 1-2-3 inning for Diaz. It's 2-0, Texas Rangers on top. Padres. Let's check in with Michelle Margot.
Thank you so much. Well, anyone who knows Andy Green knows that he's a very cerebral thinker, and a lot of that knowledge comes from reading books. In fact, he's actually crossed that over into managing, and he started giving his players books to read. He said he never suggests sports books or baseball books. Instead, he suggests books about overcoming adversity. And when I asked him what book he'd suggest for me to read, he said either a biography on Nelson Mandela or on Abraham Lincoln. So he definitely does not mess around. Guys, what do you think about that, him giving his players books to read?
Well, it's interesting, as this one is in the air to left field as Robinson is over to play it, and he'll make the catch to retire Luis Sardinas for the first out. I don't know that I've heard of that before, managers handing out some books for you to read.
I would get To Catch a Mockingbird for you. Don't you think that?
That would be really good. I don't know.
I want Fiddler on the Roof.
Okay. Are you a reader? Do you read?
I read a lot of the sports pages, and
that's it.
Seeing it, yeah, I'm gonna have to.
Yeah, well,
keeping
I know you
updated
do.
with all of baseball and the new names, the top prospects coming into the game. But yeah, I should read more.
Absolutely.
Especially those reads that I do in.
Yes.
Previous, I got to do more of those. Card
maybe
58, please.
If you read more during the off season, you'd be ready for
easier.
The promos
yeah.
during the regular season.
Well, I got to go to camp.
We may have to send you to analyst camp.
I think so.
Mark Grant took that spot last year.
I'm going to send in my invite. Send back my invite, I should say.
In the air to right center field. Struck pretty well, and that one's going to get down. Over to cut it off, Cuello, and Ibar has got himself a one-out base hit here. Batting in the pitcher's spot.
Well, Eric Ibar has consistently been an everyday shortstop, but if he's going to make this roster, he's going to have to come off the bench and handle velocity. A high fastball and drilling this into right center field. It's a nice night for the veteran shortstop.
So just the one at bat for Ibar gets a base hit. He departs and a pinch runner at first base. Alan Cordoba now running at first.
Alan.
Cordoba taken off. This one fouled off to the left out of play.
Well, Jankowski was looking to try to get on top of that baseball with the shortstop vacating his position. Cordoba taking off.
Well, Jankowski singled, stole a base in the first inning, and then struck out swinging in the fourth inning. But not running this time, and that one kind of gets away from Martinez.
Yeah, that was a good pitch to run on, too. It was a changeup out of Martinez's hands. These are also the times when I think Andy Green's going to ask some of these hitters for hit and runs more times now, trying to take those chances.
Generate some runs. Strike that time, and it's now 1-2.
Well, with two strikes, that takes that out of the equation, but Cordoba with that speed. We saw him on a stolen base yesterday.
Well, Martinez been very good so far through 5 1/3 innings. Just gave up a base hit with one out. Derek Ibar and now dealing with Travis Jankowski. There's not a lot of run through the first five. Throw to first, and Cordoba getting back to the bag, and Loney kind of playing a step off the bag. Had a back pedal there to get back over there. Not as far off as we've seen Will Myers holding on runners at first base, but he's still not on the bag.
Benefit of being a left-handed first baseman, you can let that ball travel a little bit longer and apply the tag. Well, this is the calmness that I've seen in Travis Jankowski more of this year. Working deeper counts, being comfortable in the strike zone, not being worried about having two strikes. Really the challenge when it comes down to it, Don, you see the leg kick, and it's prevalent throughout baseball. but minimizing that leg kick, trying to take movement out of it with two strikes and being able to use your hands a little bit more. A lot of guys, we used to spread out a little bit more, just punch the baseball and limit those strikeouts.
Runner goes on the 3-2, and this one fouled off to the left out of play.
Now with the leg kick, and you see the high leg kick not getting on top of that baseball. I think that's the maturing process when it comes to Travis Jankowski and moving forward. Priority number one is getting that speed on the base pass.
So Cordoba is taking off again here at the 3-2 pitch. He is. And Jankowski lines it into right field for a base hit. Cordoba just keeps on going to third. And it's first and third now for the Padres here in the sixth inning.
Now, we've seen Travis have some great at-bats this spring training, but tonight, seeing him very comfortable, had a lot of high fastballs, and he worked on top of that one. With the base runner running, Cordoba just advances the third base easily, but a really nice at-bat for the center fielder.
Well, the manager, Jeff Banister, out there to make the pitching change. A good outing for Nick Martinez. He departs with two runners on here in the sixth inning, and the Rangers on top, 2-0. Padres baseball brought to you by Petco, where the healthy pets go. And by Nissan. The choice is clear. Save on a new Nissan now. Shop ChooseNissan.com. Nighttime in the desert as the Padres and Rangers playing under the lights tonight in Peoria, Arizona. Spring training in the Cactus League schedule continues, and the Rangers enjoy a 2-0 advantage, but the Padres making some noise here in the bottom of the sixth inning with runners at first and third. Zay LeClerc into the game now for the Rangers.
I see the spring training numbers working 6 2/3 innings, also giving up 2 home runs in that body of work.
Cordoba at third base for the Padres. It is Jankowski at first with one out. They check on Jankowski right away. Brett Wallace, who took over defensively for Will Myers, gets his first plate appearance of the night. Myers had been 0-for-2 with a strikeout and a ground out in tonight's action. Wallace trying to do some damage here in the sixth inning. Runner goes, pitch swung on and missed, throw to second base, and Jankowski will be out at second, but coming in from third is Cordoba. So a double steal there and a steal of home as the Padres are on the board. It's now 2-1. Jankowski is caught, but Cordoba comes in from third base on the throw.
Well, we say take a look at both corners, and Travis Jankowski gets thrown out. Nice throw by Hayes, and then you see Cordoba. This is the read, and if you see that accurate throw to second base, easily scoring is Cordoba.
So the Padres on the board getting their first run. That run is charged to Nick Martinez, and that closes the book on Martinez. 5 1/3, 4 hits, gives up the 1 run, a walk and 3 strikeouts through 77 pitches. Now a grounder right side. Perez into the game, bobbles, but has time to recover and still gets Wallace at first base to end the inning. Padres get on the board with a run. We head to the seventh. It's now 2-1 Rangers. With the Rangers on top of the Padres 2-1. Padres getting a run in the bottom of the sixth inning, and Brandon Maurer in to get some work tonight.
Well, the closer to start the season, the roles have not been identified, but you saw the work last year at the end of the year. Spring training numbers really irrelevant when it comes down to it, but this strength of the club is the bullpen.
Cesar Pueyo leading it off here in the inning, getting his third plate appearance of the night for the Rangers. Grounded out to third base in the second and walked in the fourth inning.
Looks like that helmet's a little snug, huh?
Fouled back and a ball and a strike.
Pueyo, he's got a nice palo.
Pueyo will lift it in the air out to center. Cordoba is now in center field for the Padres, and he makes the catch out there for first out of the seventh inning. Well, some bright spots certainly for the Padres. I think heading into the season, you look at the Padres' strength, and no doubt it is in the bullpen, and they've been very solid so far during the spring.
Well, it's a strength, and also strength in numbers, where some of them are going to have to go to AAA and be that surplus and added innings. But they can shorten the game. I think it's important. At the beginning of the year, you have a lead, you have to lock it down. And they have the weapons to do that. Brandon Maurer looks like he's the ninth inning guy.
One out and James Loney batting, swinging over the top of that.
I just love that slider, it explodes. He has a high velocity of his fastball, quickens the hitters up, and it can also throw that to the back foot of the lefties.
Swung line down the right field line and a foul ball.
Seen some changeups tonight from Maurer as well.
Strike three call. Loney frozen. That grabs the inside corner. First strikeout for Maurer.
Well, he set him up, and he set him up perfectly. Showed him early with the slider, the changeup, and then the four-seamer right on the inside part. That's some really nice pitching.
nothing, two down in the inning. Brett Hayes takes the strike. He's grounded out short, grounded out to third, and kept it on the left side of the infield. On the ground again, left side. Spangenberg fires to first in plenty of time to get Hayes. And Brandon Bauer with a good 1-2-3-7. It's stretch time from Peoria, and it's 2-1 Rangers.
This is Ford Truck Month. Time to imagine what you can do in a Ford F-150. Let's crank it on up.
Sir. Nice truck, huh?
Whoa.
Yeah, we get that a lot.
Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks 40 years straight. Now get 0 for 72 plus no payments for 90 days on F-150.
To encourage trying, Goodness Knows invited people who've always wanted to create a jingle to try.
Goodness Knows! Oh, that's not happening.
Goodness Knows. Goodness Knows.
Because every try is a step to being your best.
Try a little goodness.
It's the anniversary sale at Conn's Home Plus, celebrating 127 years with 27 days of amazing deals. And only Conn's has Yes Money financing. Just go to Conn's.com on your computer or mobile phone, then join the celebration at Conn's Home Plus.
It's not how fast you mow, it's how well you mow fast.
It's not how fast you mow, it's how well you mow fast.
It's not how fast you mow, it's how well you mow fast.
It's not how fast you mow, it's how well you mow fast.
Just words to mow by, they're words to live by. The John Deere Z-Track Z345R with the Excel Deep Deck to mow faster, better. Take a test drive and save up to $250 on select John Deere residential Z-Track mowers.
Fox Sports Southwest and Texas Motor Speedway presents an incredible race experience. Race Day University with Coca-Cola is a ticket packet that includes an O'Reilly Auto Parts 500 race ticket, Q&A with NASCAR drivers, and more. Go to TexasMotorSpeedway.com for details.
Well, we're headed to the bottom of the seventh. We got a good one here in Peoria, Arizona. And every Saturday is baseball night in San Diego at Petco Park. Each baseball night features an all-star fan giveaway or experience.
This is awesome.
Don't miss the first all-fan giveaway of the season. A Padres hoodie presented by Toyota. On April 22nd, when the Padres face the Marlins, get your tickets at Padres.com.
This little dog has no fear.
Mighty Mouse.
And Nervous Solarte stands in and takes strike one. That was a pretty good battle. You got several jabs in there. While you were reading. More. Keep hitting them on the left side of the face.
Get it.
Yes. Big dog is about to have enough.
Big dog.
You had to punch him about 12 times while you were reading. It was awesome.
I felt like I got punched.
It just bounced off the big dog.
Can we bring the dogs every game?
Yeah, Solarte leading it off here in the bottom of the seventh inning. Renfro waiting on deck. That Austin Hedges scheduled to bat here in the inning.
We talked about the body of the work at the World Baseball Classic for Solarte, and even not getting the amount of bats that he thought he was going to get. So you're probably going to see him extend himself, maybe 3-4 at bats. When he gets starts. Also probably send him down to the minor leagues where he can DH, lead off every inning.
Yeah, that is an interesting part of spring training that, you know, you don't know about unless you come down here and go to the backfields to see it. A lot of the major league guys would go down there and literally lead off every inning. A lot of people don't know that happens.
Yeah. Eric Ibar did it the other day. Tony Cruz also did it.
Just to get at bats.
Yeah, and some of the minor leaguers are saying, hey, man, come on, this is my time.
Right.
What are you doing? Yeah. But it is. It's actually fun to see the big leaguers come. You're enjoying it. Watch them take those at bats and what they're trying to do. Maybe they're taking more pitches to see it out of the hands. An important aspect leading into the regular season and trying to earn a job.
Broken bat in the back goes flying into the seats and a little flip to first base for the out. But Marte looking into the seats where that bat went. Broken bat going into the seats. Always so dangerous when you see it at the ballpark. And this one split in a bunch of different directions, and most of it going just beyond the Padres dugout. And that's where Solarte is looking into that area. And getting medical attention as they take him in the aisleway, and there's more of the bat still back there. Again, a couple different pieces went into the crowd. Very scary.
So dangerous. And we touched on it in our broadcast yesterday with the screening at least past the dugouts. Let's see Major League Baseball step up and try to implement that in every ballpark.
Two and oh the count here to Hunter Renfro. We have one out in the seventh inning. Swing and a miss. Good fastball running away.
I've seen Hunter Renfro. He has that leg kick, but that back leg is slipping out behind him. Wondering if that affects his balance at times. Obviously the raw power is there and he can generate a lot of bat speed.
Fooled him that time. Took something off, and it's now 2-2.
You know, I think that's going to be the adjustment around the league, and I think Hunter Renfro is going to have to try to stay in the strike zone, which they're trying to implement that especially. But you're going to see a lot of breaking balls, hard sliders to Hunter Renfro, and he's going to have to prove that he can not only hit them but stay off the ones that are purposely thrown for balls.
So full count now to Hunter Renfro, who has grounded out to third base and flied out to left. So far 0 for 2 in the game. Payoff pitch. And a swing and a miss on the fastball by him. First strikeout for Leclerc, second out here of the seventh inning.
Well, pitching backwards early with the breaking balls and then late with the fastball, that's really has good carry by Leclerc.
So two down here in the seventh inning brings up Austin Hedges. Hedges tonight has flied out to left and grounded out to first base. Field straight away here on Austin Hedges. Yeah, a swing and a miss and a ball running in on him that time.
Well, he saw it big and it ran because it has a little bit of that carry, that velocity brings with it, that carry in the hitting zone. 2-0 count, you look at, you see it big, swing right through it.
Fouled off to the right, out of play. And it evens here at 2-2. Rangers got their two runs in the first inning. Padres coming up with their run in the bottom of the sixth inning. And trailing by a run here, batting in the bottom of the seventh. Rangers got very good starting pitching tonight from Nick Martinez, who went 5 1/3, giving up the one run. And Clerk's been good since coming in. And he's able to strike out Austin Hedges. As 1-2-3, seventh inning, we head to the eighth. It's 2-1, Texas. Paul Clayton Richard getting the start tonight for the Padres. Had three strikeouts in five innings. And Richard with another good outing here tonight. His spring training's been pretty good for Clayton Richard, giving up a couple of runs in tonight's game, but five innings of work and pitching out of some jams as well.
Saw some good signs tonight from Clayton. Also, the four-seamer came into play at the top of the strike zone, which I think he's going to implement a little bit more this year. But the two-seamer, as we see, Ryan Buchter coming in after Brandon Maurer. Those roles were going to be reversed as the season starts, but he's had a really nice spring training. Five strikeouts in only three innings of work. We saw a great story when it was Ryan Buchter last year. Very aggressive with that fastball up in the strike zone.
Pretty impressive outing for Brandon Maurer. Looked very good tonight.
You got to almost drum up the intensity in yourself, and Brandon Maurer looked like he did that tonight. Also saw some pretty good changeups to go along with that slider. And the fastball location was very good. He's getting ready for the season.
Cruz has taken over in behind the plate for Austin Hedges. So a new battery here entirely. Ryan Buchter and now Tony Cruz.
Kind of an underrated signing for the San Diego Padres. He spent the majority of his career backing up Yadier Molina in St. Louis. Last year in the Kansas City Royals organization. He's battled some injuries this spring. Hasn't got the at-bats that he probably would like to have, but catching is his forte. Also receiving pitches and working with a staff. I think the luxury of Tony Cruz and being able to be behind the plate, but also watching Yadier Molina at his craft on an everyday basis, having those conversations.
Strike three call, and Buchter with his first strikeout, one down here in the eighth inning.
Well, again, the fastball into both sides of the plate. Cruz sticking it on the outside part.
Series of changes here for the Padres, and it looks as if Bethancourt has taken over in the outfield in left field. Told he could get some work in the outfield today. We have seen him catch. We have seen him pitch, but he's not played in the outfield yet this spring. And Andy Green giving him that opportunity here, and what an interesting experiment that's going to be this year.
Yeah, and Andy said it today that he's trying to get him some work in left field. We saw him last year a few times showing athletic ability in the outfield, both in left and right field. But I would say if Christian Bethancourt's going to make the club and being able to get some starts in the outfield, it's going to be against those tough lefties that are in the division.
Came up with some big hits last season.
Mm-hmm.
This one is popped up from first base. Wallace running in. The pitcher, Buchter, taking charge and making the catch in foul ground.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by the authority of the San Diego Padres. It may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the San Diego Padres.
Two down here in the eighth inning.
It's my favorite read.
You really enjoy that. That one you didn't even look at the copy.
Card 58 is very difficult.
He struggled with card 58.
57 was tough.
I laughed through one of yours, which was really unfair. Made it very difficult for you to read it.
The dog. He slug in the
quite about. I mean, it was great.
It was. It's like Rocky Balboa.
It's awesome.
Taking a
shot. I thought the big dog was going to go down. A couple more body shots, and that dog was going down.
Body blow, body blow. Knock him out.
The 0-1 is popped up foul off to the right out of play.
It's like Floyd Mayweather just taking little jabs at him.
I mean, but it went on forever.
It's a shot, the shot. There he is, the shot.
This looks a little bit more fair. You have two.
See the tail wagging?
Size. Yeah, they like each other.
Yeah. Everyone's like, Mom, can you get me out of here? There's too many fights out here on the lawn.
We've seen several bounce throughout the night. Ten in a row retired here by Padres pitching right now. Combination of Diaz, Mauer, and Buchter. And that is strike three. Another good inning of relief for the Padres. This time it's Ryan Buchter. It's a one-run game. To the bottom of the eighth inning, Rangers have a 2-1 lead, and Ryan Buchter looking good. Rangers have the lead over the Padres. You get ready for the bottom of the eighth. We send it down to Michelle.
Thank you so much, Don, here with Yanhervis Salarte and David, the translator. Yanhervis, you just got back from the World Baseball Classic representing Team Venezuela. What was that experience like?
Bueno, ¿cómo fue la experiencia? Tú estabas ahí, acabé de regresar del Clásico, representando Venezuela. ¿Cómo fue la experiencia?
Una experiencia muy bonita. A pesar de lo malo, no pudimos pasar más a la tercera ronda, pero ya con todas esas estrellas, ya uno... como que se siente, o sea, con esa oportunidad de estar ahí, de tener toda esa experiencia y poder agarrar un poquito de cada uno.
Yeah, no, I mean, it was great. I mean, a really good experience, despite the fact that, you know, we weren't able to advance, we weren't able to go on to the third round, but, you know, with that group of stars, right, you know, it's really good just to be around them and try to, you know, get something from each one of them.
How is it just being back in Peoria?
Como es estar aquí en Peoria en spring training de nuevo.
Importante que verdad necesitaba venir a agarrar mis turnos. Ya estoy con el equipo, tratando de hacer los pequeños ajustes para empezar la temporada. Contento de todo esto.
No, really good. I mean, good just to be back with my teammates here. You know, I think it's good to be able to get some at bats, get some time, and then make some small adjustments to be ready to start the season.
How was it just watching your teammate hit a bomb?
¿Y cómo fue ver ese home run?
Si supiera que estamos aquí en la entrevista y no dejé de verlo, ¿está? Bueno.
Yeah, no, I mean, of course, you know, we're doing an interview. I wasn't really able to see it, but good.
All right, thank you so much. Back to you guys.
All right, thanks very much, Michelle. Great to have Yanhervis back in camp again and looking forward to the season for Salarte.
Yeah, I'm really excited for him to get back at the base of at-bats and also get into the season healthy and also see how he is at second base, how he performs at second base.
There's a liner to left field for Spangenberg, and that's in for a hit. Well, Padres have tied it up on a home run. Albert Martinez into the game earlier, and his first at bat did this.
Well, Martinez takes that fastball. What a moment it is for him, getting called up from the minor leagues. Number 93 on his back, and he ties the ball game. What a great swing and a great moment.
Well, Dusty Coleman coming up here for the Padres. Runner at first, nobody out. Padres now looking for the lead after tying the game 2-2. Dusty Coleman with big league time with the Kansas City Royals in four games in 2015. Last year at AAA with Omaha all season. Another throw to first, and back to the bag is Spangenberg again.
Now Dario Alvarez has taken over for the Rangers, and that was the first run allowed for him in his 7 1/3 innings of work in the spring. Been a good story for the Rangers.
Yeah, well-pitched night tonight. Nick Martinez with the first 5 1/3 for Texas, giving up a run. Jose Leclerc going an inning and 2/3. No hits and no runs. And you see the numbers for Dario Alvarez. A 1-2 Coleman. And that one's by him, 0-2.
Looked like he took a little off on that pitch, an offering that looked like a changeup inside to the right-hander.
Dusty Coleman signed as a minor league free agent. Swing and a miss, and he strikes out. Alvarez gets the first out here at the bottom of the eighth inning. And it's with the strikeout of Dusty Coleman. Alan Cordoba coming up here for the Padres.
Well, perfect scenario. Speed on the base pass in Corey Spangenberg and also Cordoba. See, a first pitch. Corey Spangenberg takes off on the first move against the left-hander.
Cordoba has played in the infield. He's played in the outfield, shown a lot of versatility and got a lot of time during spring training. From Panama. Rule 5 draft choice from the Cardinals. As Alvarez kind of slings it over towards first base. Leadoff home run, Albert Martinez ties the game for the Padres, singled by Spangenberg, and strikeout of Dusty Coleman. So one out, one on in this tie game. There goes Spangenberg, is swinging a foul back. A little hit and run, and Cordoba fouled it back.
Now, too bad, because Corey Spangenberg got a good jump on that one. You see the jump against the left-hander. Ari went over a couple times, and Corey takes that leg kick, and I think would have stole that base easily, but the foul ball, he has to go back to first.
Speed is truly an element of his game, though. And certainly that was part of the problem for Spangenberg coming back last year with all the leg injuries, as Cordoba strikes out for Alvarez back-to-back K's, and there are two outs here in the eighth inning.
On a pitcher's count, and you see Alvarez with that leg kick blowing that fastball by Cordoba.
Christian Bethencourt batting here with two down in the inning. Took over defensively in left field an inning ago, and see what he did in 73 games last year, primarily as a catcher. Six home runs, 25 runs batted in, and remember a big home run he had against John Lackey in Chicago.
In Chicago, when the Padres really played very well against the eventual World Series champions. And Bethencourt had a big to-do with that. On the doubleheader, he hits the home run. John Lackey didn't like it, did he?
No, he didn't. He stared him down. Kind of a check swing. You're going to appeal. Did he go? No. And Walcott, first base umpire, said he didn't go.
He just got to know where his mind is. And Christian Bethencourt, so many things thrown on his plate. I'm trying to be a pitcher. Now he's in left field, pinch hitting. Is he going to catch a little bit? That's very unique at this big league level.
He goes, and they guessed right. Can they get him? They do. Spangenberg gunned down at second base. But a home run. Albert Martinez has come off the bench and homered for the Padres. And tied the game at two at the end of eight from Peoria. Martinez, who just hit a solo home run to begin last inning, the bottom of the eighth, and tie the game 2-2.
Oh, in comes Brad Hand out of the bullpen and part of the three-headed monster right now. Brad Hand last year, 89 innings, 111 strikeouts, and pitched in many roles. But you got to love the left-hander and the adjustments, and coming from the Marlins last year and being able to put up those numbers. A lot of people in baseball are talking about the bullpen for the San Diego Padres and the elements. That's the reason why the phone is ringing to try to pluck some of these guys. But what a great bullpen it is and the success that they had last year.
So 2-2 the score here into the top of the ninth inning. So the numbers for Hand, he's been spectacular during the spring.
Yeah, I think the challenge too is duplicating what you put up last year, setting that bar. It's always the hardest thing in the major leagues is being able to have that successful year and get off to a really good start the following year.
Now if the spring is any indication, he is getting ready for another big season.
I just love it that they're comprised with guys that just stick their hand out to Andy Green. Give me the ball. And that's a very good trait to have as a successful reliever. You had Carter Capps, who he, if he is healthy, adds to a successful bullpen and adds another power right-handed arm. It's a good combination to have two power righties and left-handers that you can get the big strikeouts.
You mentioned Carter Capps, and we've not yet seen him in a game.
Well, he's done a couple innings of work in the minor leagues and trying to get some health. He's only 12 months out of Tommy John surgery. But that was an under-radar pickup in a trade with the Marlins. Because when he is healthy, it's a very unorthodox delivery with a lot of velocity behind it, but also he has pitches to go along with that fastball.
Tied up 2-2 here in the ninth inning. Perez facing Hand and a payoff pitch. Swing and a miss, and Hand strikes him out for the first down of the ninth inning.
It's not only velocity, but the movement with that velocity of the fastball.
Well, Luis Marte coming up here now for the Rangers. With one out in the ninth inning. Line to center. Cordoba is there to make the catch, bell tie for the second out of the inning. Sharply hit, but Cordoba was out there. Brings up Jared Hoying. Hoying had taken over in right field last inning, and now bats for the first time, kind of an upright stance, open from the left side.
Now why the open stance? So many times it's visually being able to put two eyes on that release point. What they do is close themselves out, but they want to be able to see that pitch. And sometimes when you're set up where it's squared, you're not able to get that head around to put two eyes on the baseball.
Seems guys who struggle against left-handers in a lefty-lefty situation try to make some adjustments to help themselves out. This might be what it is.
Yeah, and I've seen some people that have done adjust against lefties, and then they square up against the righties. It's just something to try. You're trying to get to a position where you feel successful against those tough lefties.
Chop down the first baseline, foul. And it's 2-1 now to Hoying.
So interesting to see the dynamics of how many different styles there are. But when it comes down to it, it's the movement and getting yourself in a good hitting position when that pitcher is releasing that pitch. If you have different timing aspects to your swing and to your setup, you're going to have to start early.
Another chopper foul, 2-2.
Luis slowed him down with the breaking balls. The previous two pitches. Let's see if he goes elevated with that fastball.
This is down low, and it's a full count. Right now, the Padres pitching staff has retired 13 batters in a row.
Now, we've seen Tony Cruz, the catcher, behind the plate, too. He looks very comfortable behind there. Haven't seen much action with him.
Popped up left side. With two outs in the inning, this should be out number three and end the inning. Corey Spangenberg taking care of it. We head to the bottom of the ninth, tied 2-2.
And don't miss this year's Padres Fan Fest presented by T-Mobile. Fan Fest will be hosted at Petco Park on Saturday, April 1st from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. This family-friendly event features autograph signings, a kids zone, games, and much more. Redeem your free tickets today at padres.com/fanfest. Face painting, balloon animals, and R.J. Alvarez taking over for the Texas Rangers.
Former Padre R.J. Alvarez played in or pitched in 10 games for the Padres. A 1.13 earned run average for the Padres back in 2014. Last time he was in the big leagues, though, was with the Oakland A's in 2015. 21 appearances out of the pen. And last year, spending the year in the minor leagues.
Well, 7 strikeouts in his body of work in spring training, and he has a power slider to go along with his fastball.
Christian Bethencourt leading it off. And a swing and a miss at that power fastball for strike one.
Christian Bethencourt is trying to get him over. Over the fence. I like that. Sitting on that fastball and taking a rip.
I have to wonder a little bit about Bethencourt's timing at the plate. Has not seen a lot of at-bats during the spring.
Yeah, and taking the mentality aspect of the challenges he has in front of him. But I don't think that's going to change his style. We've seen a longer swing at times, but also the power in the bat that we've touched on.
Okay, you haven't hit much in the spring, which is harder to hit, curveball and fastball?
Well, the fastball is one of those things that you feel very comfortable with, but it's timing. It's timing yourself up, and you feel sped up if you haven't seen a lot of pitches. That's the challenge. But the breaking balls aren't as sharp down here, typically. You'll see some real good ones, but also those ones that spin.
In the air to center field for Bethencourt. Bollinger going back at the wall. That ball is gone, and the Padres walk off with a win. And it's Christian Bethencourt who hits that home run. He has pitched, he has caught, and tonight he's played defensively in left, and tonight he has a walk-off home run in the ninth inning for the Padres. Christian Bethencourt, what a story he has been. So a walk-off home run here gives the Padres a 3-2 victory and another look.
Well, down with two strikes, he gets a fastball out over the plate. And he knew it was gone because he powered the baseball, has that power. And it's a walk-off win for the San Diego Padres.
R.J. Alvarez will take the loss in this game. He served up the home run for Christian Bethencourt. How about that? His teammates out to salute him as the Padres walk off with the win, winning tonight 3-2. We'll step aside and come back with more from Peoria right after this.